Yeah, August the 2nd, Thursday, another early morning, 6 o'clock. Just loaded the bikes, now the hotel, I'm making a quick breakfast, lunch box for, so I'm a bit on the road again. See how far we get today. Doesn't look like there's a hotel until 117 kilometers, but let's see how it goes. Like a mini ask about this town here. What new looking modern town in the middle of a desert. Looks like it's going to be a flat day today. Mainly through agricultural fields here. Going quite nicely though. Nice section of road here, so the bike's rolling. 25 now, it's quite good really. Not much wind so far. Let's see how it goes. Hello.
Oh,
hello. Donkey going the wrong way up the road. Amazing what a small donkey can actually pull. Weight, we've got 40, 60 kilos on our bikes, and if you donkeys, I must have at least 200. This is the main road here to Tashkent. We'll be turning off this a little bit later this afternoon. Now the plan today was to do 117 kilometers. Oh dear. Longest ever distance on this trip, but so far the road's flat. We even have tailwind, so we're doing 25 kilometers an hour, just rolling really. So let's hope that continues. It's 7:45, and we've done 35 kilometers without any effort really. So let's see how it goes. It's nice to do lots of sightseeing, but actually I enjoy the most is just the day on the bikes, just watching the world go by and finding places to stop on the road. Maybe because we've just had a month of sightseeing. But, now it's really nice to be on the road.
Okay, so we can have our breakfast over there. It's 40 kilometers so far. So, do you have some breakfast?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, nice breakfast stop here.
Was in the shop and me too was buying some cakes and this and we want coffee but the first thing the lady looked was me. She said, "Do you talk Uzbekistan?" And I said, "No." So everyone in the whole trip also look at me and say, "Look like I can understand that I can talk their language, but no, I cannot talk their language."
That's one thing we're noticing now, that people think that Jamie starts looking like all the Uzbeks here, so they think he's Uzbekistan. It'll be difficult to work out he comes from Peru. But, that's funny. Start of the second stage of the day. Let's see if we... It's a nice breakfast there. Get back on the road again. And how often do you see a flock of sheep being taken for a walk down the highway?
Okay.
No day in Jamie's handing out cards. Look what we just got for lunch from the policeman here, watermelon. I stopped here at the border control and got a free watermelon.
So people in this country are very friendly.
Yes. Turn around and start to walk away. What do you call a wide load? Okay, if you want to bike around the world, not all of it is luxury hotels and high life. You also have to use things like this. This is the toilet here, where you get sunburnt as well. But the benefit of this place is that there's also another Persian restaurant here where we're having lunch, and you can sleep and have your lunch at the same time. Okay, this is traditional Uzbek lunch. It's called plov, some rice and meat and carrots. It's really nice when you can find it. So salad and chilies. That's our lunch today. And asleep on the table after lunch. Can't get better than this.
In the shade. We really need shade now. But anyway, we started at 6 o'clock this morning. It's actually gone really well because we had flat and completely smooth asphalt, so that's been really nice. So we did really well. 40 kilometers in there. It was a place where we could stop and have our breakfast, which the hotel gave us in a little box, and we could even buy a cup of coffee there and some cold juice, so that couldn't be better. And then we biked again, and now we just found this nice restaurant. We didn't think there was going to be a restaurant, but there was, just after 85 kilometers. Now we can sit here and enjoy the lunch in the shade, so that's really nice. So, and a funny thing, yesterday morning before lunch, we saw stalls, boder, that sold potatoes. In the afternoon, there were stalls that sold apples. And today until now, there were stalls with melons. So that changes like which area you go through, apparently.
And in a few days we'll be in Fergana Valley, and that's where they're one of the watermelon capitals of the world. There should be lots of watermelons. We even got one on the back of our bike at the policeman gave us. Okay, let's have some lunch. The best thing is it's only 12:05, so now we're in under the shade now for the next few hours while the sun is at its highest. I already feel my arms are starting to burn a little bit, even though we've got quite a high factor sun cream on. But I think if we just keep out the sun between 12 and 2, then it seems to be okay. Okay, we couldn't stay in the restaurant because they needed the tables, so we couldn't sleep in the restaurant. I know we just spend the few hours here in the midday heat here. Yeah, it's a nice place. Even a stream here. Children playing. And the water there. It's funny, these places, like the little boy there sleeping just there. They seem to have their outdoor beds here. I think they sleep outside, a lot of them, I think, in the summer here. But he'll have a rest of him. There's a donkey. Hi, donkey. Okay. Hello. Not too bad, really. Not a bad way to spend the noon here. Just to avoid the heat. That's the view. Oh yeah, this is good. Okay, 3 o'clock, the worst of the middays. Heat is over, and get back on the bikes again. Nice sleep we just had. Just as we're leaving, the lady from the house near the river, she asked us if we need some tea. That would have been nice. And yeah, just had a sleep. Now, let's get going again. The roads or the scenery aren't really interesting today. It's just pretty flat. Oh, actually very flat. Flatter here actually than in Denmark. Actually, it feels like as flat as Holland here. But never mind. On the day when we need to do 115 kilometers, then it's quite good really. Just what we needed actually. These horses and donkeys we just see standing at the side of the road. They don't have any shelter from the or shade from the sun here. They stand there all day. Record 110 kilometers and straight to the hotel. Oh, that was good. Get the air conditioning on. Let's get in the shower.
Yeah, we need
this was the longest destination we have
done. Okay, and we're in a town called Gulistan. Just checked into this hotel here, had a shower, that was nice. And we did 110 kilometers today. In three stages. But, that went quite well really. The roads were extremely flat and we had a tiny bit of tailwind, so that helps. So it's the most kilometers we've done, but it wasn't that difficult really. It's quite easy. So we had a nice breakfast on the way and stopped this afternoon under a tree. The only problem we have at the moment is the sun now. It's extremely strong between about 11 o'clock until 3 o'clock in the afternoon. You can feel your skin start burning, even though we've got some high factor sun cream on. It's yeah, apart from that, it's okay. The morning riding is really nice, and the afternoon after 3 o'clock again, you can get back on the bike and ride, so really good. So nice day, having a hotel here, great. I'm gonna have something to eat now, and then it'll be the same pattern tomorrow. So I think got another day on the bikes tomorrow, and then the day after we should actually be in the mountains in a nice mountain resort we found, so that should be good. Be nice to see the mountains again, so. We're going to have some dinner now here in Gulistan.
And this is the pizza we are eating today, and he is making the pizza. And this is the things he needs to make the food.
So today is pizza party. Yesterday was burger party, now it's pizza party.
I'm again funny being so far away in Uzbekistan, but they know Danish football player Christian Eriksen again. And this guy, he knew all Scandinavians when he was learning geography in school. That was funny.
Well, this is the town of Gulistan. The tourist attraction, but just a town to stay in this evening. So that's okay, just for one night. I'll be back on the road again in the morning, 6 o'clock. We're just talking to the guy that owns a pizza restaurant. He lives 25 kilometers from here. And I asked him, do you have a car or a motorbike? He says, no, he just takes a taxi. So, and I asked him, what does he pay for a taxi? Because we're paying about 10 or £1 just to be taken different places in the towns. But he pays 60 pence to be driven 25 kilometers. What we're thinking is not a taxi as we know it. It's kind of car sharing is what we've seen. Outside of the cities, you don't see yellow taxis, but you see people jumping into normal cars. I think it's a car sharing price, maybe. Another thing here, it's a nice restaurant here. I mean, instead of cutting the lawn, they just get the sheep out in the evening. Do a nice job as well of cutting the lawn there, I can see.